Hello and welcome to the Literary License Podcast Christmas special. We are live from East Finchley, North Finchley and Connecticut. I'm with the lovely Ramona, Mario,
hello from Hartford.
Hi.
And David Grant.
Hey.
I'm your host, Craig Johnson, the one and only. We are tonight doing The Lion, the Witch and the Wardrobe by C.S. Lewis, the 1988 TV serial from BBC TV. This was the it was first broadcast in 1988, and it is the Narnia is the home of the great lion Aslan.
Yeah.
During his long absence, his arch enemy, the evil white witch, places Narnia in an eternal winter. However, with the return of Aslan and the arrival of the four Pevensie children, who are also from Finchley, the Narnians can hope to end the tyranny of the witch.
Yeah.
Let's cut to the trailer and we'll be right back.
Coming soon to BBC One, The Chronicles of Narnia, beginning with The Lion, the Witch and the Wardrobe, C.S. Lewis's classic tale of magic and mystery in a faraway land.
Wardrobe. There's a wood inside it, and it's snowing, and there's a form that I had tea with, and a witch, and the place is called Narnia. Come and see.
The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe, coming soon to BBC One.
Hello, and welcome to the Literary License Podcast. Tonight we're discussing The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe, 1988. What are your thoughts, guys?
I bloody loved it. I think it's one of my favorite ever serials. Honestly, guys, I mean, I watched it my first time when I was 8 years old.
Yeah.
And I was in awe. And that was the book that got me reading.
Really? That got you into, yeah.
Well, do you know what? I remember watching this in year five or six of my primary school. And it was the 80s. And the teacher would bring out this massive TV on a big wheelie stand.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And we would just be so excited because we were like, wow, we're going to watch something on TV. And it was either that or we'd watch the Through the Dragon's Eye.
Yes. Oh, my gosh. Yes.
I used to love
Look
that.
And read. Look and read.
Yeah. So this brings back a lot of childhood memories for me. And I rewatched it with my mum last week because I've got the box set. And I just think it is...
That's the one.
So
that's
beautifully made. Like, it makes you feel so Christmassy and warm. And when you see the costumes, and I don't know, I was trying to work out where the location was for this.
Do you know what? I was trying to find out where it was, and I was looking, and there was no indication where it was set at all, anywhere.
It looks like it's set in Scandinavia somewhere. I don't know why. It's got that feel about it, you know? It looks like... doesn't look like England.
Because it was definitely cold because you could see their breath.
Well,
because I thought it was studio, but I realised when they walk through that cupboard, they are freezing.
Maybe they go to Newcastle.
And they put those big furry coats on.
Yeah. You know, well, I've had the Lion, the Witch, the Wardrobe. Right, we'll go through the wardrobe, we'll end up on the Tyne River. Bloody freezing.
It's enough to freeze your Winnie
bagel. It's enough to freeze your Narnia off. Yeah. Anyway, that's
Oh, hold on. Right. I've just found out. They filmed this at Marnorbia Castle in Wales.
Ah, Wales.
So I reckon then it's possibly around the Helvellyn area then, where it's really cold and there's a lot of snow and ice.
That's kind of weird. They would choose that spot because that's where the original King Arthur, well, Winchester, I know. And Winchester was like where the round table was, but the whole legend, you know, the original... Britons or the Welsh, you know, we're just invaders.
It was just amazing. All the sets they did back then for that type of show, the CGI and everything was incredible. You know, all the little demons that come out of the forest that, the witches hags.
Big Mick was little man.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, and Leslie Nichol. I don't know if you know Leslie Nichol. She was Mrs. Beaver, but she is also the cook in Downton Abbey.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
So I like when Edmund is being a little brat.
Yeah.
And he comes out, and she and the queen, he meets the White Witch, and she gives him
Turkish delight,
and it always makes me so hungry.
Yeah.
The way they acted that, because it was so cold,
yeah,
and it just looked so warm and enticing.
Yeah.
And she was a really scary witch.
She was. I mean, Barbara Kellerman outdid herself.
Yeah.
She's amazing, honestly. But I tried looking to see if she's done anything.
Barbara Kellerman.
Yeah. Right. And she's done nothing since, you know, then.
Yeah.
But she scared me. She literally scared the shit out of me. Yeah. When Edmund went back into the house, I'm sorry, I'm not supposed to swear. I'm not sure if we're allowed to do that.
Yeah,
but I apologize, everybody, but she did scare me. And she said, "How dare you come along? Didn't I tell you again? And the others with you?" And I was like hiding behind the sofa. I literally jumped. Like, you know, I'm so scared. And he was younger than me.
And she kills Father Christmas. I mean, that's bad.
No, that's pretty
She
bad.
Freezes him.
What?
No, did
into
she?
Into stone.
What, into a popsicle?
Doesn't she turn him into stone?
No, she doesn't do. And I think you got the... Were you watching the right one, Craig?
Yeah. Father Christmas is there on his sleigh, and then she just goes for him.
No.
I think it's me.
But
watching the deleted scene.
Bert Parnaby played Father Christmas.
Yeah, but he's not a Narnia. Bloody hell.
She didn't slay him. I mean,
she did kill him. Yeah. Oh, I thought she did. Okay.
But he gave presents to the three children, Peter, Susan, and Lucy.
Yeah.
The bow to Susan with the horn.
You think Lucy got the teeth done now?
And she got the dagger. Lucy got the dagger with the medicine.
Yes.
Yeah. That's it.
She wanted to fight in the battle, you see, but he wouldn't let her.
Do you play this with your students?
What, the Lion, the Witch and the Wardrobe?
Yeah.
They actually do the story in year four.
Oh, right.
In the wardrobe. And I actually did the library book display outside the library.
Okay, yeah. Cool.
Which was, show you after, put it on the group chat. But, you know, they watch this version every year.
Oh, brilliant. Because it's weird that you said it, because that you mentioned about doing this podcast, because I gave my little brother the Lion, the Witch and the Wardrobe box set books that were mine, and I gave it to him for his birthday this year.
Yeah.
What did he think of them, you know?
I'm not sure. I have to find out. He's going to have to find out at Christmas.
Well, it's like, it wasn't, hold on, C.S. Lewis and Tolkien.
Yeah, that's the ones I've got. Yeah, I've got them.
These are the ones which I found in Covent Garden Market for £5.
The book jackets are beautifully done.
Really nice. Very
amazing.
Yeah.
Because Tom Baker's in the silver chair, isn't he?
Yeah. Yes, he is. He's in all parts of the silver chair. That was, for funnily enough, that was my least favourite of the series.
Right.
The silver chair.
So the movie was like
Prince Caspian.
Loved it. Loved the Prince Caspian one. And it was like they don't believe Lucy, but she's seen Aslan, and then they do believe her as well. It's just it. The whole of it is amazing.
Adam.
And what was great
was, Eve,
it was that there was an arc with it towards the end, and you didn't realize that the professor was the boy at the beginning of the very first book. Professor, I can't remember his name, in The Magician's Nephew.
Okay.
Yeah, wow.
He has been to Narnia. You could see in his face, once a king in Narnia, always a king in Narnia. Once a queen, he would say that to them at the end. And he had been them himself as a boy.
It's beautiful. You know, they use music to sing the world into
the film. I know this is sidetracking because I'm talking about the film, but the film made me very emotional because after I watched The Dawn Treader, I realized it twigged that they were actually just, it was such a traumatic event, the Second World War, that they were using that as an escapism during it being evacuated out of their homes.
Maybe.
And they used Narnia as a fantasy world to escape the reality of war.
Yeah.
And that really made me emotional when I watched the movie. And that's more, it's more adamant in the film than in the series.
They played it down a lot in the TV series, didn't they? A lot rather than the actual film.
Yeah. What were your standout moments?
Well, obviously, the witch shouting down at Edmund when he came through to the house, which was amazing. The battle between the White Witch at the end as well was fantastic. I mean, I can't...
The sacrifice of Aslan.
Yes.
On the table. Yes.
Yes. Yeah. I mean, I'm sorry, everything stood out for me. It was just like a magical kingdom, you know.
The lion's like quite a symbolic,
isn't it?
The Jesus Christ moment.
Represents Jesus, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's very Christ. And also in like Rastafarianism, you know, with Bob Marley, you know, you have the lion, the Zion, where you have the lion, you know.
Right, yeah.
The lion's, this lion, Richard the Lionheart, you go all the way through history, it's always a lion. The lion is strength, you know.
And a unicorn. But,
yeah, the unicorn is the third eye. It's a euphemism, you know.
Yeah.
Or the third eye, but fabulous. C.S. Lewis was a big friend of Tolkien.
What were the ratings?
I don't know.
It was six episodes.
Six episodes.
Yes, from the 13th of November, which was my dad's birth, which is my dad's birthday, till let me just find out. Bear with everybody. I'm very sorry. From till the 18th of December, 1988.
Right.
So this was when the Candyman was on the telly.
Yes.
Happiness Patrol.
It's on PBS here in the United States.
Yeah, you got it first time in the 90s, Ramona. Yeah.
I don't have any viewing figures, unfortunately.
No viewing figures at all on this one. But there have been many versions of The Lion, the Witch and the Wardrobe. Yeah. There was a cartoon version.
Yeah.
As well, and they've done audio of the actual dramatized audio, which I've listened to, and there were elements from the TV series from that audio to the, you know, to the TV series, but it was very, very different.
Does anyone know what the guys are doing now, Peter?
I tried to get him to come on to our show, but Peter Dempsey, if you are listening, please, please, please come and join us one day. We would love to talk to you about The Lion, the Witch and the Wardrobe and all your work that you do in the theatre, because he's now a theatre, in theatre production. He is also acting as well still. Susan, who played by Sophie Wilcox, I'm very sorry, Sophie Kirk. Yeah. She was in The Worst Witch with her twin sister.
All right.
In the 1988, I think 85 or 86 film with Feruza Balk.
I'd like to find out from Jeffrey Perry how long it took to put all that hair on his chest.
Like the character Big Mick as Little Man.
Yeah.
And I mean, Sophie Wilcox hasn't done anything since.
The fox used to freak me out a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
He's very sly looking.
More grim. Yeah. More grim.
I think the Mighty Boosh used that idea for their crack fox.
Ken Kitson was giant rumble buffin.
Oh, yes.
Not backwards.
What a name.
Excuse me, Mr. Rumble Buffin, would you come forward?
Hey, you up there?
Yes, hey, you up there? Come down here. Oh dear!
I loved Mr. and Mrs. Beaver. They got me emotional towards the end. You know, I felt like their parents. They were like their parents throughout the whole thing.
They like the Golden Compass kind of used a lot from these ideas. You know, I guess you know they're all flying around with the same sort of like concepts.
Alan Seymour wrote this with adapted C.S. Lewis's story
from the book,
and the music was composed by Jeffrey Bergen. and it was produced by Paul Stone. I think they did a brilliant job.
No, it's really
What
cool.
would you rate this then, Mario?
I love the music to it. It was just gorgeous.
Mm. Yes.
What would you rate it?
10 out of 10 completely.
Yeah. I'll give it 10 as well. I really loved it. I've got the box set.
Yeah. Well,
it's one of those stories I could watch over and over and over again at Christmas time.
Yeah.
And then, of course, it resurfaced again in the 80s as the old girl band Banana Narnia Rama, you know. So,
I should be so lucky, 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 lucky.
Oh, no, it's the other one.
That's Kylie Minogue.
Yeah, sorry, yeah. Oh, I can't forget. I'm going to get shot for that. Hold on, Banana
Rama. De Niro's waiting with a big log here.
Yeah. Yeah,
and my gonk here.
And your gonk, yeah. You can say they could form a band. The log and
the gonk.
Yeah, the gnome and the gonk. Yeah. I think a 10. I'll go 10. With, yes.
And Ramona?
It was one of the shows that I ran home from school to watch.
Yeah.
So definitely a 10.
So we've got a 30 top.
Yeah.
Well, that brings us to the end of the Literary License Podcast Narnia Christmas Special.
Yeah.
So, but thank you for joining us, and we wish you all a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
We wish you a
Happy
Christmas.
Wish Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Lordia.
Good night, guys.
Good night. Over the river and through the woods to grandfather's house we go. The horse knows the way to carry the sleigh through the white and drifting snow. Over the river and through the woods, oh how the wind does blow. It stings the toes and bites the noses, over the ground we go.
Over the river and through the woods, now grandmother's cap I spy. Hurrah for the fun as the pudding done, hurrah for the pumpkin pie.
Over the river and through the woods and straight to the barnyard gate. Spring over the ground like a hunting hound, for this is Christmas Day.
Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas. Hark, the bells are ringing, hear the children singing. Merry Christmas,
Merry Christmas.
Merry, Merry Christmas and a glad new year.
Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas. Hark, the bells are ringing, hear the children singing. Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas. Merry, Merry Christmas and a glad new year.
Over the river and through the woods, we must hurry, we mustn't be late. We seem to be going extremely slow, it is so hard to wait.
Over the river and through the woods, while the wind does blow.
Hurrah for the fun is the pudding done,
for this is Christmas Day.
Merry, merry, merry Christmas, merry, merry, merry Christmas. Hark, all the bells are ringing, and here are the children are singing. Merry, merry, merry Christmas, merry, merry, merry Christmas, merry, merry Christmas, and a glad new year. Christmas, merry, 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 merry Christmas.
And a glad new year.